In this video, we are going to understand the working of gyroscope. In the previous video, we have learnt about accelerometer. If you haven't checked the video yet, you can find the link in the description below. The gyroscope is one of the sensors found inside an IMU, that is an inertial measurement unit. We find a lot of appliances having motion control built into them. To give a few examples, many of us play games on our smartphones. By tilting or rotating the phone, a certain character can be controlled. Similarly, the controller of Nintendo Wii works using motion control technology. This is made possible only because of the use of sensors which measure acceleration, rotation, and sometimes even magnetic field acting on the body. The part about acceleration measurement is already covered in the video of accelerometer. In this video, we will visualize how the rotation on a particular axis is measured using a gyroscope. Before starting with the construction of gyroscope, let us first understand the basic physics principles that allow us to measure rotation. The Coriolis force or the Coriolis effect helps one measure rotation or angular velocity. Consider a body of mass m as shown in the figure. It is moving in the x direction with velocity vx. Suppose an angular velocity omega acts on it in the y direction. Then the body of mass m experiences Coriolis force. This Coriolis force is a vector quantity and is perpendicular to both the velocity in x direction and the angular velocity in y direction. The magnitude of the Coriolis force is proportional to the mass of the body m, velocity vx, and angular velocity omega. The direction of this force can be found out using the right-hand rule. For the mass m shown in the figure, the Coriolis force acts in the z direction towards the viewer. Once we understand this principle, we can calculate the angular velocity by measuring the Coriolis force. The technique of measurement of force or acceleration is already covered in the accelerometer video. The same principle using capacitance would be used to measure Coriolis force, however, with some minor changes. The gyroscope uses a two-mass system which keeps moving in opposite direction continuously, having same magnitude of velocity. When this whole system experiences angular rotation, both the masses experience Coriolis force. However, they have opposite directions as per the right-hand rule. One can visualize it easily from the animation shown. The final value is taken by finding the difference of measured acceleration of the Coriolis force. As the acceleration is a vector quantity and both the accelerations are in opposite directions, they get added up when they are subtracted. As a result, any other unwanted forces acting on the system can be easily neglected, and they do not affect the measurement. As seen in the animation, we can see two blocks of mass m moving continuously in opposite directions. When they experience angular rotation, Coriolis force acts on these blocks and they move in upward or downward direction. As a result, the capacitance across the plate changes as the distance d changes. By measuring delta d, we can calculate the magnitude of Coriolis force and thereby calculate the angular rotation from the relationship discussed previously. This whole assembly is built as MEMS of the scale of micrometer. This makes it possible to manufacture small ICs for gyroscopes. Having such systems placed in all the three axes helps to find the angular velocity in x, y, and z direction. That's it for the current video. Hope you have learnt about the working and construction of MEMS gyroscope. Give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. We will discuss about the measurement of magnetic field using magnetometer in the next video. Subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon to never miss an update from Practical Ninjas. Stay calm and keep learning. Until next time, peace out.